Hi everyone, the video that we are about to see is the continuation of unit 3 Matter Around Us. This is the fifth part of the unit 3. To watch the previous videos, you can check out the description box. Topics to be discussed are different methods of separation, methods of separation, threshing, sieving, churning, magnetic separation, hand picking, filtration, winnowing, sedimentation, and decantation. In the last class, we learned what is separation. So we know that the method of separation depends upon the properties of the components of the mixture. Now, let us learn about the different methods of separation with examples. There are several types of separation techniques that are used in separating the mixtures or substances. Usually, separation is done to remove all the unwanted materials and to obtain useful components. Some of the common methods of separating substances or mixtures are the things that we are going to discuss. Threshing. Threshing is done mostly during the time of harvesting crops. Farmers separate grains from their stalks by beating them so hard that the grains are separated from their stalks. This is called threshing. So this is mostly done during the harvesting of crops. Grains are the harvested seeds of grasses such as wheat, millet, rice, and so on. Then the stalks, that is the main stem of the grains. Once they harvest the stalks of wheat, they are dried. Then the grain is separated from the stalks and grounded. That is, they will touch the ground, that is floor, by beating the dry stalks to shake off the dried grains. So this is the process of threshing. So mainly the farmers used to separate the grains from the stalks by beating them in the ground very hard so that the grains will be separated from their stalks. So this is called as threshing. Sieving. A sieve is similar to a strainer. We have mixtures or substances of different particles. A sieving is used to separate the solid particles of different sizes. For example, you would have seen your mother sieving the flour, isn't it? Yes. A sieve is similar to a strainer. Sieving is used when we have to separate solid particles of different sizes. So the example for sieving is barn from flour, sand from gravel. So what is barn? Barn is husk, the brown outer covering of the grains in the rice and all you would have seen. That part is called as husk. So that is left when the grain is made into flour. So your mother will be sieving it to get the flour and barn separately. That is one example for sieving. And another example is sand from gravel. During the construction of buildings and all, you could have seen that gravel is very small stones. So to get a nice soft sand, they will be doing the sieving and they will be getting the sand for the construction of houses. So that is one example for sieving. So here the picture in what you are seeing, that is called as sieve. You would have seen in your kitchens. Churning. Churn is to move or to make water. So churning is the process of shaking up something, okay, of shaking up cream or whole milk to make butter. So the mixture is churned vigorously when solid butter will be collected on the sides of the vessel. So mostly they will be using this churning process for converting the solid butter into buttermilk. So vigorously means strongly or powerfully. The mixture is mixed or shaked very strongly so that the solid butter will be collected on the sides of the vessel. So after churning, we can be able to get both butter and buttermilk. We can consume them. Both butter and buttermilk obtained after churning are useful and can be consumed. You can observe here in the sides of the vessel, we are obtaining the solid butter. So this is the process of churning. So by doing like this, they will be obtaining both solid butter and buttermilk, and both are useful. Magnetic separation. So this method is used to separate magnetic elements from the substances or mixtures. In a mixture containing iron, the magnetic property of iron can be used to separate it from non-magnetic substances by using a magnet. So by using a magnet from a non-magnetic substance, we can separate the magnetic substance. So by usage of magnet, you can remove the magnetic materials from the non-magnetic material. So substances that are attracted to a magnet are called magnetic. Separating solids using a magnet is called magnetic separation. So the one which are attracted by the magnet, they are called as magnetic, and solids can be separated by using a magnet. So that kind of separation which we are doing using a magnet, that is called as magnetic separation. Hand picking. How do you identify a stone from a grain of rice? If the stones are visibly very different from the grain, they can be easily picked and separated by hand. So this is called as hand picking. Already in the last video we discussed, I hope you remember, you separated the green peas from the plough, isn't it? By using the hand, picking out the unwanted materials and separating them is called as hand picking method. So this method involves simply picking out the unwanted substances by hand and separating the useful ones. Hand picking is a method to remove slightly larger impurities like pieces of dirt, stones and husk from wheat, rice and pulses by hand. You would have observed your mother picking the stones from the rice before cooking. Okay, so this method is called as hand picking method. Filtration. So from the name of the method, you will find what is filtration, isn't it? Yes. The method of separating liquid from an insoluble solid is called filtration. The method of separating insoluble component, sand, mud, etc. from a mixture using a filter paper is called filtration. So in the next video, we will be discussing how to separate a muddy water. In that, we will be discussing in detail about filtration. For now, filtration, it is a method of separating liquid from an insoluble solid. For example, water and sand, if I mix together, the sand will not be soluble in the water, isn't it? So that is a insoluble component. Separating that mixture using a filter paper is called filtration. You can see in the picture over here, they are using a filter paper and they are pouring a liquid into it so that the solid particles will be staying on the filter paper and you will be getting the clear liquid in the beaker. So this kind of separation is called filtration. Winnowing. So when the grains are collected from the process of threshing, it will be with impurities like
husks and chaffs.
Husks are the outer part of the grain, isn't it? So it will be containing more impurities like them. This is done by dropping the mixture slowly from height in the presence of wind. So when the grains are collected from the process of threshing, it will be with impurities, isn't it? Already I told you it will be with impurities like husk. So in the presence of the wind, the lighter particles will be carried by the wind and they will be falling apart as a separate heap. Then the heavier solids, they will be collected in a separate heap. Okay, that is the grains. They will fall closer and they will be forming a separate heap. So, this process of dropping the mixture from the height in the presence of wind, that process is called as winnowing. Lighter solids, that is husks, will be carried by wind and will be collected in a separate heap. Grains will fall closer and form a separate heap. Sedimentation. Let us take a beaker and fill it with the mixture of sand. If we leave it for some time, what happens? The sand present in the water will settle down at the bottom of the beaker, isn't it? So that is called as sedimentation. Okay. The rice or pulses are washed in water. The lighter impurities float while the heavier rice grains sink to the bottom. This is called sedimentation. So when your mother is cooking rice, before that she will be washing the rice, isn't it? So when she is washing the rice, what happens? The dust and all will be floating in the water. And the rice which is heavier, it will be settling down. So that settling down of the heavier particles is called as sedimentation. Decantation. After sedimentation, the water with impurities, okay, already we had the rice settle down and we had water with impurities, isn't it? So when we want to cook the rice, what we have to do? We have to pour out those impure water. We have to pour that impure water. So after sedimentation, the water with impurities, it is carefully poured away by leaving the clean rice at the bottom. So this process of pouring the liquid after settling down is called as decantation. The water with impurities is carefully poured away, leaving the clean rice at the bottom. This is called decantation. So the same example also we can take, the muddy water. Okay, so what will happen? The sand or the mud, whatever we had in the water, after leaving it for some time, it will be settling down and we will be having some impure water in the beaker. So pouring out that impure water without the mud or sand, that process is called as decantation. These are the common methods of separation. We have many more methods of separation such as evaporation, distillation, sublimation and centrifugation, etc. Do you know? Centrifugation is a technique used for the separation of particles from a solution. So according to their size and shape and so on, this process will be done. In washing machines, this principle is only used to squeeze out dirt from the clothes, and that method is called as centrifugation. In washing machines, they are using the principle centrifugation so that it is used to separate or to squeeze out the dirt from the cloth. So this is called as centrifugation. Summary of the video. We discussed about the various methods of separation with the examples, threshing, So farmers use this method to separate the grains from the stalk. Sieving, this is the one which we use to separate the particles, solid particles of different sizes. Example, we saw barn from flour. Churning, this is used to separate the solid butter and buttermilk. Magnetic separation, this is used to separate the magnetic materials from the non-magnetic materials. Hand picking, simply we use our hand and we separate the unwanted materials from the mixture and we get the useful one. Filtration, this method is separating liquid from an insoluble solid. Winnowing, this process happens after threshing. The grains are dropped from the height so that the lighter particles will move out in air and separately form a heap, and the grains, useful grains, will be falling closer and they will form a heap. Sedimentation, so if we take a mixture of sand and water, the sand takes some time to settle down. So the settling down of heavier particles, that process is called as sedimentation. So decantation is the process which happens after sedimentation. Here the liquid will be poured without disturbing the mud or sand. Okay. The process of pouring the liquid after settling down is called as decantation. These are the different methods of separation with examples that we discussed. Hope everyone understood. One more part of Unit 3 is to be continued. Please do like, share, and subscribe. Thanks for watching.